To me, there's no better way, whether you're a pleasure angler or a matter angler like I am, I love my pleasure fishing as well, than coming to a fishery and catching great big carp in the margins. Now, I've brought you to, I think I keep saying it a lot, a beautiful fishery, but this is a beautiful fishery. We've had a lovely breakfast. Me and Zot have had a lovely breakfast this morning in the cafe. It's called Cob House. This is a fishery that I used to come probably 4, 5, 6 years ago. It was a lot of small fish. Now I've been told, and it's a great opportunity to bring the cameras back to a beautiful fishery. Like, there's loads of lakes here. And I've been told the carp have grown up and they're a lot bigger than what they used to be. There used to be a lot of 3, 4 pounders in these lakes. Now, but as we know, big carp can be very, very tricky to catch. I've got a nice selection of baits. I've got some fishery pellets. I've got some sweet corn. And that's really what I'm going to stick to, I think, is pellets and corn. I haven't brought much else with me, really, because I don't really know the fishery anymore. But anyway, I've picked a lovely peg with a nice big snag in it. I'm not sure about, like, plumbing up and things like that. Hopefully I can find a certain depth. But until I sit down and go through everything, I don't know. So what I'm going to do is get back to my kit and run you through everything you need to know about catching these big carp in the margins. Well, to me, there's no better way than fishing the margins for some of the biggest fish in the actual lake that you're fishing. And that's exactly what I'm doing now. They're not always the easiest fish to catch. And that will depend, I think, on depth of water as well sometimes. If you go to certain venues, they're deep down the edges. You know, you go to certain venues, they're shallow. And finding the correct depth of water, if you can, always have a good plumb up. You know, even if you get the right depth in close, hopefully if the fish come to you, just an indication then. So when I go to sort of lots of venues, really, you might not catch really close at the start of the session, but as the session goes on, they can come obviously short to you, even like catching right by your keep nets, especially in the summer months. But also when you've got cover. Now I've got a lovely tree, even though it's quite, you are like literally fishing in the danger zone. It's great fun because you can, there we go. So I'm just fishing at the moment. One of my favorite ways of catching down the edge to avoid foul looking fish. That's a good fish. Luckily that one's just come away from the tree. It's sweet corn. It's heavy. Sometimes you've got to introduce micros and maybe even ground bait if the venue allows. I'm at Cob House today, which is a venue I've not fished for absolutely years. And it's an absolute stunning venue. There are tons and tons of carp in here. Of all different sizes, well into double figures, some of them. Look at that. And having the right gear on is really important. I mean, I'm fishing 17 Dura slip. I'm fishing with 021 main line. And I've got an 019 hook length on to a 14 XSO2. So it's all balanced tackle. And when you're catching fish like this, especially in the summer, you need that sort of kit. You know, I've got a big bush to my left, which the fish are just going to love to swim around. A little bit deep when I plumbed up this morning, I've probably got, I would say, 2.5 foot. Ideally, I would like 18 inches, but I can't find that today. But and then you've got to think about how you're going to feed it. My first impression was put a few micros in, fish corn on the hook. I caught one or two doing that. And I've just changed over now to feeding corn only. I'm not getting as many fish in me peg, but the fish I am getting in me peg, I'm hooking, which is the most important part. That's a lovely common carp. And if you get it right and you go to the right venues, these are the stamp of fish that you can obviously expect to catch. I'm going to hold this one up because it's absolutely beautiful. I'm not putting the fish in the keep nets today. Basically, just enjoy the fishing and let the fish go. But that's what you can expect. Double figure carp like that. Probably just under double figures. That probably nine to nearly 10. Look at that. It don't get better, does it? You know, no rushing, just balanced tackle, and you can get these out no problem at all. So let's run you through the kit. Let's get him back. So kit wise, like I said, 17 Jura, got a nice medium cab pot on there because I am putting a little bit of bait in. 021 mainline, which I've already told you about. And then a 6-inch hook length of one of the new XS02 hooks in a size 14. Now the 14 in those hooks are quite big. I'm just putting a single bit of corn on. Simple, bulk, no messing. I've got 4 number 8s on there and then a little adjustment style stop. And I've got one of the new 4x12 edge XS's. Nice big thick top. When you're fishing with big baits, big hooks, that and fishing distance as well. I'm fishing 13 meters down the edge. And I'm just picking out, I've got some salted caramel corn, which I love because the quality of it is second to none. I'm just filling that pot up with that, like that. Just pat it down a bit. I'm fishing with a superior carp as well because of that tree. But don't go, you know, just keep everything smooth. So I'm just trying to cut that corn in just a little bit away from the bank, like that. And drop that straight down. The problem is with a lot of venues, they want to come off the bottom. And you're just trying your hardest. There's a little ledge there, just as I come in from that, I've plumbed up. And there's a real steep little ledge, and it's a bit too shallow. But I found a nice little area there. And there ain't many, if I put micros in, they come in, they're off the bottom, they're sort of, you know, tailing everything up. That's it at the moment. Obviously, things can change. I will introduce micros again if nothing happens, but I'm quite happy by just being like nice and patient, potting in corn, something, you know, nice and heavy. Obviously, you've got to stick to the fishery rules. A lot of fisheries, you know, you're not allowed to use other baits like meat and stuff like that. A little indication then. There's obviously an odd little silverfish, probably a little, I've had a couple of little carp as well. It's probably a little bit undercut as well, that bank. Oh, that looks like a little fish indication then. And with that short line, you don't have to strike either. You know, you literally just lift up. Oh, look at that. That would have been a carp, I'm sure of it. That's part of fishing down the edge on heavily, you know, stock waters like Cob House. The problem is if you go down there and start blasting pellets and that, there we go, you're better off. Oh, straight into that tree. Just keep it down. You don't have to go crazy, you just get enough tension on. That's why 17, you can even step up to a 19 if you want, but I just thought, and you'll find that's only a little carp, and they're the ones that actually do you. The big fish are normally a little bit, they just sort of come away from the bank. And even with a small carp like that, that's 17, probably a little bit heavy, but you don't lose the fish, especially with a nice big hook on as well. They're absolutely stunning in here. Look at that. You can go from £10 to a beautiful little mirror like that of about £1. And at the moment, I'm quite happy just plodding along. Nice big chunky bit of corn, just hook it down through, nothing special. And is filling that medium cab pot up with corn. There's probably, if you look at it, it's probably like 80 pieces of corn in there. You soon go through a couple of tins. It's nice and smooth. I've got my roller nice and high behind me, so you can just keep everything as smooth as possible. So just slightly out from where I'm fishing. And I think sometimes you go, for me personally, I always take some dead maggots with me. And that will depend on the fishing, you know, the fishery, the depth of water that you can fish in. And obviously how it fishes on the day. Some days, for me personally now, a lot of fisheries have got a lot of tiny fish in. And they can be an absolute nuisance with baits like maggots. But I've also been to fisheries some days where they just turn off. There's no surface fishing. And that's when obviously you can put maggots in, especially in deeper margins like I've got today. There's one in me peg at the minute, but it's definitely off the bottom moving around. A big thing that is. Oh, that was a lovely one. Not going to give it too long until I come back and feed some more bait. That's definitely the thing, what you've got to remember is not just sitting there, unless it's a venue that you know and you're only fishing for maybe a few fish. When you're fishing for like a good weight of fish, coming back, feeding again, just treat it like you do with your method feeder fishing. You know I've always said about using a stopwatch, you know, you chuck the method out. And how many times have we gone through it? You know, you sit there for 10 minutes, not a bite, you chuck it out, you get a bite within 2 minutes. And that can be the same as down the edge fishing some days. You have to come back and put a better bait in, which is what I'm going to do now. I'm just going to put mostly corn, just with a few micros over the top. Just got to be careful with these micros, because I don't know the venue. So just play it easy, so you can always put more in. There's a lot of big fish in this lake. There we go. So just capping that corn off with a few micros got me a fish straight away. The problem is with it, you just got to go careful, because you can't always keep doing it, because you just drive them mad, especially during sort of mid-match and things like that. Because when you start match fishing, I think we all know, you know, at the end when they're probably wanting to feed, you might be able to get away with it more and more, but during your sort of first 3 or 4 hours, so the power tops, it's important, you know, get the power tops with the right elastics in. Gives you so much confidence. And not, you can probably tell from now, I'm not pulling, I'm just nicely, it's just not what I call nice fishing, controlled fishing. Obviously got me roller putter bush in. Feels like a nice fish, eh? Not an absolute unit, but another one of those 8-pound fish. Yeah, it's great, isn't it? I love it, Heidi. I think it's great when you get great big fish like that. Oh, perhaps he's a little bit bigger than what I thought that one. Oh, yeah. Oh, I can't believe it weighs that much. It's probably 11 pound, I would have thought. Perfectly hooked. And obviously, there is there's occasions nowadays, especially when you've got deep edges like I'm fishing, that, you know, if they do come in your peg, you've got real problems in catching. You can only really do it, I think, when you've got like, probably like I got here, like 2, 2.5 foot steady, mate. Absolute lunatics. Is actually trying 6 inches off the deck or somewhat like that. Just trying to concentrate on getting the hook out of this. There we go. I'm not even gonna hold him up. Proper workout today, catching them all day. I said, just fishing 6 inches off the deck, especially when you've got deep edges like I've got today, it's always worth a go. And obviously today, if it comes to that, I will try it. Doesn't work on every venue you go to, but there is occasions. And that will depend on obviously little fish problems as well. That is the only thing with deep edges. Some days on certain venues, they can be absolutely brilliant because you don't see the fish that are coming in your peg. I know it all looks fantastic and you see tails up, and but you all at some venues, you've got a job to catch the fish that come in your peg. Can be really difficult. Deep edges, like I said, deep edges can be an absolutely, they can be awesome. As you can feed it nicely, get odd bite, everything's in the mouth. And also, try fishing a little bit more of a depth, like a float length. I'm only fishing with little edge excess, which is probably like 4 inches long. And what I mean by that is you plumb up to the bottom of the stem. That can be really, really good some days. Normally I just try and plumb up like I normally do with the body sort of an inch out of the water and then take it from there. There we go. Oh, that's angry. He's off into the middle of the lake, that one. So just try those little things. Might have been fouled up that. Not too sure. He's off into the middle of the lake. Just trying to put a few form. I'm just really reluctant at the moment to put those micros in. Just trying to stay away from them for a minute. I have caught one or two putting a few in, but also get a lot of stupid indications, even though I can't see tails or anything like that. Just trying to stick with like corn and bigger pellets now. There we go. Oh, go into the tree, get away from that. So just come back like that. Oh yeah, he's just come out now. That was a bit right under that tree. And it's, like I said, it's not the big ones. That's unbelievable. When I looked at that, I thought that was a great big thing. But he's not, he's about paying that. It's incredible. They're the ones that do you. Beautiful fish, though. Look where he's hooked, right in the nose as well. You'll find that quite a lot, where they sort of come up. Absolutely stunning fish, though. Look at him. One for the future. So, I mean, when you go to a lake like I am today, you've got to bear that in mind that, that's why you've got to come back, feed a bit more bait, because if you get a few of them, they'll mop your bait up. So just hook that corn nice and deep. Bit of corn. Just introduce a few 4 mils. Because they definitely come to the smell of those pellets. I've got a bit of banoffee liquid on me pellets. That, you know, obviously you've got the smell of that. You've got the smell of the corn. It all helps, I think. I think, you know, smells and stuff. You've got to use fishery pellets here, so like putting a bit of that liquid flavouring on. There's other things I can try. Obviously, I can make a little ball of micros. Instead of putting the micros in loose, I can put a little ball in. That is definitely something that I'm thinking about at the moment. If they come to micros, but putting the micros in loose causes problems next stage. Or even like the first thing I could have done was put my, you know, balls of micros in. I might try that, because definitely, you definitely putting micros in gets the fish in your peg. Let me just put a little ball in. You sit there for like just a couple of minutes. you just as well come back and feed again, because if you don't, nothing really happens. So let's get those nice ball. Try and get it just away from where I'm fishing. Right there. And just bring that float just up behind it. Definitely makes it a bit awkward, that side wind, but that's what you want. You want it to go down, that float just sits there and wallop. And a bit of a boil there, but you know that's not on the bottom because it's too deep, unless that carp's 3 foot long. Which he could be. See that then, little tiny indication. There we go. Okay, that. Gotta just put that ball of micros in, get him away from that tree. That feels like a good fish. Definitely gotta go careful with some of these. Don't take too many sections off. That one's just come straight out from the bank. All the big ones have basically just swam away. They sort of go towards that tree and then just go past it with the little ones, try and get into the roots. I'm not going to chip that down to the top kit. I'm just going to take a couple of sections off just in case it does steam off. They've been wallowers and then all of a sudden they get a bit of steam up. Not been snapped up once, but definitely putting those nice sizable balls of micros in has been the key, no doubt about it. Single and double grain of corn. Feeding a little bit of corn now and again, totally changed from what I was doing at the start. And it's been absolutely mega, you know, just because of the depth of water, really. There's a lot of venues we go to, I think, where the depths are like a bit different to like the real shallow venues. And them little balls, I do that a lot, fishing on the edge and also in deeper water. I put corn in earlier, that was good, but then they just faded away a little bit. If I stayed on until later on this afternoon, they might go back on the corn again. But unless I put those micros in, the fishing's just not as good. With micros, you are literally getting one a chuck from, well, anywhere from 2 pound. I've had some lovely cruisings as well. But balanced tackle. That 17 has been absolutely mint, to be honest. I can still use a little bit down the roller puller end. And for these size fish, look at that, great big com. I've had them up to like 15 pound. This one's not far off of that. Might just be under. But them XSO2, size 14s, 019 bottom. And balanced tackle. And you can enjoy your fishing with balanced tackle, which I think is the most important part. I could have stepped up to a 19 jawer, but I think that 17, with that odd stocky in that, I think it's absolutely ideal. All I've done, I've actually got my bulk. I had a little bulk on earlier, and I've just sort of stretched the bulk out, and I've had a couple on the drop. Oh yes, yeah, I've had a couple on the drop on corn, but that's a nice fish. That. Oh. Tell you what, fair play, Cob House. They are absolutely beautiful and a brilliant size. Let's just get that hook out of there. Get this off to. I'm going to try and hold him up. They're not very happy about being held up, these fish. That's probably 13, maybe 14 pound. I've absolutely enjoyed this session massively. There's nothing better than catching these sort of fish in shallow water. Seeing the bow wave go off. You don't know what you're going to hook next. Look at that. Cob House special. I'm going to definitely be coming back because I've not been here for some time. I've hopefully picked up some nice tips. Don't forget to like and subscribe on the Preston YouTube channel, and thanks for watching.